What is going on, everybody? Albetsky44 here. I want to talk quickly about Destiny 2 Shadowkeep, which is the new expansion, the new non-Activision Destiny. They do have a collector's edition for this one, which looks cool. I'm going to go into some of the details and is it worth it or is it not? I do like some of the options they are giving you here, which is really nice to see. But yeah, Destiny 2 Shadowkeep, next expansion, comes out September 17th for PS4, Xbox One, PC, and then Stadia as well. Is cross save now, so you can have your character on multiple platforms. There was nothing about like cross play or anything like that, so you can't like play with Xbox players if you're playing on PS4. But if you have a PS4 character and you also play on Xbox, you can move that character to Xbox or PC or vice versa, which is cool. That's something that I'm really happy about, because I do have it on PC. I never really played it because PS4, you know, is my main console. But now with that happening, I could play back and forth, which is really neat to see, because I have a lot of friends on PC, a lot on PS4 as well. This Shadowkeep Collector's Edition, I do like. From what I've seen, I'll just go through it here real quick, what you get. If you want the edition with the game, it's $150. This comes with the Deluxe Edition, which is basically Destiny 2, everything that's come out for Destiny 2, and then the new Shadowkeep expansion as well. The expansion by itself costs $35, so if you already have the Destiny 2 and all the different expansions and you just want to upgrade to this, $35, you could get that in the PSN store, the Xbox Marketplace, or wherever you're going to be playing the game. They also have the Collector's Edition without the game code, so that you just get all the physical stuff. That's $90, so basically $60 less so no game. $60 less, that makes perfect sense. I like that they're doing that, giving players the option that have been with Destiny since the beginning. That way you don't have to buy the game again and not use it. So that's really cool to me. If you are getting the one with the game inside, it is a digital code only. There's no physical disc. That's something else to keep in mind. Like I said, it's $150, comes out September 17th. If you get the one with the game, of course, you get the Digital Deluxe Edition, which I said comes with all the extra DLC. Everything that's come out for Destiny is what it comes with. You also get some in-game bonuses, some emotes and stuff as well. You also get the Digital Destiny 2 Shadowkeep Original Soundtrack, which is cool. So next, we get to the Collector's Edition with the actual physical stuff. The Collector's Edition exclusive in-game emblem, an exclusive in-game emblem printed inside the physical collectible bundle. That's pretty cool. You get a Hive cryptoglyph replica, which is the thing, the biggest thing in the Collector's Edition. You get that, which is pretty cool. It actually moves. It has secret contents, which is pretty neat. I'm kind of interested by that, because you have to actually unlock it to get what's inside. I'm sure people are just going to tell you on YouTube, but that's just kind of a fun thing that they're doing. You get a Metal Luna Mission Container, Metal Luna Mission Folio that holds historic relics and records. That's kind of cool. You also get a Luna Mission Handbook containing 40 pages of schematics and design documents. And you get a Luna Journal, which is a 160-page journal featuring additional story content that is bound with mysteries, charms, and talismans, which is also really neat. Artifacts of the Golden Age is the last thing you get, which I'm not sure what that is exactly. They don't go into detail. They just say you get that. Looks like you get some patches and stuff too. The box looks pretty cool. The artwork looks cool. I mean, this is just cool. If you're a Destiny fan, you're going to get this. I'm really debating. I actually did not get the original Destiny 2 Collector's Edition. That bag, I mean, it was cool, but it was just something I was never going to use. This is something I would use. I like books. Like, I've gotten all the Destiny books that they have released. I have all the other ones pre-ordered. I love reading them. I love the lore. I love the comics. Everything in Destiny is so cool. And I like this replica, too. That's something just to have cool. That's not, would be on the shelf. And it's just my type of collector's edition. Because you gotta remember, if you have the game already, it's only $90. That's really not that bad, because you would be paying $35 already for the Shadowkeep expansion. So thinking of it that way, you're paying, what, $65 more for all this cool stuff? I think it's worth it. If you don't have Destiny 2, and this is your first time playing it, $150 is a little steep, I'd say. If you know you're going to invest in it and know you're going to play it a lot, get the collector's edition. If not, you could get this stuff a lot cheaper. The Destiny 2 game, it was free on PlayStation Plus for a while, so you might have it there. All the DLC is probably pretty cheap now as well. So definitely, if you're not into physical stuff, just get the digital edition. Get it cheaper. Might have it free already. That's worth it. The base game, I'm pretty sure you could get at GameStop for like $7 right now. So that might be the better option for you. For me, though, like I said, I'm probably going to get the no game code version for $90. I'll do an unboxing on this channel once it comes on September 17th. And yeah, that's about it for this video. I wanted to talk about it because, you know, I am a huge Destiny fan. I love playing it. The PvP is still my favorite PvP on PlayStation. That's what I've played more than anything else, PvP wise. And can't wait for this stuff. I want to see where Destiny is going without Activision. I think they're going to start making better decisions now. I think it's going to be an all around better game. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think about this. You can hit me up on Twitter at LBetsky44. I'm also on Twitch at LBetsky44. As always, guys, I appreciate you watching. Leave a comment and peace.